was all before the word got around that a killing mad car was headed their way. So the sheriff and the boys were gonna stop him out on the highway, right where it intersected Big Black Rock. So it wasn't long at all before the whole town was out standing round, hammering a nail and building up a pride in a roadblock. Just hanging around a roadblock. The mayor's wife sat in the shade and talked her way through a few good lies, while her husband practiced his acceptance speech for a medal from the FBI. And Granny rocked back in her chair and said, just what did this man do? While some idiot kids from school ate dirty snow cones colored red, white, and blue at the roadblock. Just hanging round the roadblock. Just hanging round the roadblock. Just hanging round the roadblock. Then the local paper jumped the gun and printed the big headline, town is safe from killer car with roadblock at state line. 3 miles down the highway in a Chevy 69 were a pair of crazy eyeballs jumping left and right in time. Through an 8-track tape playing fog hat and Jethro Tull, and a gasoline-soaked hand shifting a little plastic skull, and on the arm a blue tattoo that read, I'm a son of a bitch. A map open on the front seat, leather black as pitch. 1 foot slammed on the gas, no shoe, just an Argyle sock. And that car was screaming wild down the highway like lightning toward the roadblock. Right towards the roadblock. Then all eyes turned down the highway to a big cloud of smoke. And Granny went into a mild state of shock and started to choke. Then a boy up in a tree yelled out, here it comes. Then 20 men strong aimed and fired point blank. 19 shotguns. Well, the next day the sheriff just tried to stall while they buried the body out behind a wall. The newspaper said, killer still on the lam. Seems the boys at the roadblock shot the wrong man. Nobody really knew just who he was. He was driving a Camaro with dashboard fuzz. They all burned the car right there in Big Black Rock, and no one ever said a word.